Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to the channel. It's Cynic Alex, and today I want to give you my day one update thoughts on the 4.1 patch for Infinity War Part 2 with the 8 uniforms, the 7 new level 70 characters, and the glut of changes made to the game with stuff in the Shield Lab, with stuff in World Boss Ultimate, etc. As usual, not all of the changes that were made in the game were listed in the patch notes. A lot of things were missing. Some things needed more details added to them, and some things that were in the patch notes are not yet live in the game. So I wanted to cover those things first before I give you some preliminary opinions on uniforms, so that'll come at the end. So one of the biggest changes that was made with this update is to the Shield Lab, and one of the things that they didn't mention in that is the item shop. It's actually going to be extremely important for kind of low spenders, and especially those of you that want a guaranteed way to get CTPs and premium cards. When you level up your item shop, you will improve the different types of items that you can get from the mission shop. So as you can see here, in my case, I've purchased all of the gold purchasable items. I did not purchase the crystal item, which is the superior obelisk, and I was able to level up my mission shop just above me to 100%. Doing that unlocked my kind of mission shop premium purchase, which in this case is one Blast Titan Record. And it costs 1,250 crystals, which I do not want to purchase. But in addition to that, you have a whole bunch of other different items, and some of these might look pretty amazing to you, but as you scroll down, and keep in mind, as you level up your item shop, you will unlock more of these items. So if you don't see all of them, that's because your item shop is not yet at level 15. We see regular cards, non-premium 6-star cards, we see Uru, we keep going down, we start to see some pretty intense items. Ultimates bios, CTPs, premium cards, and then the combat records and the Titan records for speed, combat, and blast. So I think the major spoiler here is the CTPs and the premium cards. Previously, we were getting them either from legendary battle rewards that were kind of every few months, kind of random, and required uniforms and required a bunch of crystal purchases. Now you can purchase them outright if you get them out of the mission shop bonus item. Now, of course, it's random what item you get, so technically you could be months without seeing a CTP, but I've already heard reports of people seeing premium cards, seeing CTPs, so it's not that unlikely, I think. And the actual cost for them is pretty reasonable given the cost in the shop if you purchase them through the kind of RNG gacha box. It's 6,750 crystals per CTP and per premium card. The cost for the other items I'm going to list here, but I'm not actually going to discuss. I think all of the other items that we've data mined so far in terms of their cost is not worthwhile. I think the only items worth spending crystals on that can appear from this mission shop are the CTPs and the premium cards. While 6,750 crystals is extremely expensive, by no doubt it's a very expensive purchase. If you think about it, it's 10 purchases of the regular chest, and 10 purchases usually equates about one CTP. But if you don't like to take chances, if you don't like RNG, and if you just want to choose which one you get, because that's the other thing, it's 10 chances, but you might not even get the one that you really want, even though the chance to get the refinement one is upgraded or increased, as or so they say. You could get a destruction or an energy, so it allows you to choose exactly which one you want, and it allows you to take all of the RNG and all of the guessing out of the equation. I think this is a fantastic addition to the game, and I kind of applaud, in a way, Netmarble for doing this and giving us a way of purchasing it outright. It would be nice if we could choose what item we get from time to time, maybe a limited time event where you could do so instead of having a random item, but that's kind of besides the point. Keep in mind that I wouldn't purchase the CTP of Transcendence or the CTP of Patience this way for crystals. I would only reserve that for the four other CTPs that are specifically and exclusively purchased from the boxes or the legendary battle. For the premium cards, it's kind of up to you, but I wouldn't personally get these last three at the bottom, and I'd also skip the two Loki cards because you know where you can get them. So it basically just boils down to these other cards here that are unobtainable any other way. But that's a pretty awesome, pretty pleasant surprise. A couple of things to note from this item shop, for those of you that don't know, and don't want to experiment. If you upgrade your item shop, it will, like if you upgrade it from level 10 to level 11, it will refresh all of the items in the normal shop, but it will also reduce your mission shop bonus stage back to 0%. So if you're very close and you've purchased most of the items, don't upgrade it. Additionally, once you collect enough of the dimension tokens, you can refresh the list. It will refresh both the normal list and the mission shop list. So again, I wouldn't do this unless you really want to see a different item there and you've already purchased it, gotten it up to 100% and seen what it is and don't like it. But you will have to spend quite a bit of gold. I spent probably around 3 million gold getting all of these items in order to see what my mission shop item was, because it's a mystery until you unlock it at 100%. But this is a pretty interesting and pretty dope addition. And of course we have the warp device where you get those dimension tokens from. The other big change that we had, or one of the other big additions we had, is that in the feature shop, a lot of the basically all of the packs now are selling these tokens, and a lot of people are confused, where do we use these event tokens? Well, you actually use them in the consumable page, which is the third tab in the feature shop, and it's just your regular list of items that you can purchase that we've seen many times over with these kinds of events. Not really discussing the packs in too much detail, but if you are going to be getting them and you are going to be amassing tokens, while the Mega Tier 2 Advancement Ticket is obviously very attractive, it's 400 tokens, it's a lot, I would consider, or I would kind of position you to consider the Fully Awakened ISO8. Yes, you can get an orange one, yes, you can get a purple one, but if you get any of the other ones, it's actually very good, and one Fully Awakened ISO8 is worth 21 regular 6-star ISOs, so you can consider the cost there. And it's basically impossible to farm ISO consecutively, especially the 6-star variety. You can farm uniform XP, so it does devalue this one, and you can absolutely farm uniform upgrade kits. So again, would you rather have 100 uniform upgrade kits, which you can farm in a couple of days with a lot of energy, or 2 Fully Awakened ISOs, which is equal to almost 50 regular 6-star ISOs, which would be hundreds of, you know, 3 or 4-star ISOs, plus the millions of gold that you'd spend upgrading them to 6-stars. But that is just my opinion. One of the other big changes we had was to World Boss. We had 2 additional World Boss Ultimate stages added. Proxima is joined by Corvus and Black Dwarf. Unfortunately, one of the items that was listed in the patch notes that isn't listed here or isn't available live in the game yet, it might be after today's reset, an hour after this video, is the option to change your World Boss of the Day. As of yet, I have not been able to figure it out, and no one else that I've come into contact with, that I've talked to, has been able to figure out. My World Boss of today is Thanos, and I was not able to change that, but I did experience and I did play against both Black Dwarf and Corvus, and I have to say Corvus seems to be the scarier one, but my opinion might change once I get to a higher level with Black Dwarf. But at least for now, in the first 5 stages or so, Corvus seems a bit more challenging and probably is going to end up being more of a headache than Proxima. So yeah, if you had trouble with her, her husband might be even more tactfully frustrating. And then we had changes as well to co-op. I want to show you guys, or I could show you guys if I built up the stage enough, but basically we had 2 more co-op buttons added, or 2 more co-op options for rewards added for VIP 17 and 20. Now this is not going to apply to most of you, because most of you are not VIP 17 and 20, but for those of you that are very close, either at 16 or at 19, they added 1 slot for Uru and 1 slot for cards, and it has been confirmed that you can get the at least the semi-premium cards from that, and those semi-premium cards would be not the ones that have the P on them, but the ones that are only available through the comic chest in the shop for crystals. The one that I saw in this case, or that someone saw and told me, was the shield number 12 card. Not a premium card, but essentially a premium card, because it's only obtainable through the card chest until now. So that's a pretty exciting bonus addition for the VIP, the very high VIP players. We were told in the patch notes that they were getting 2 new options that they could roll items for, but we didn't know what items they were. So now we know it's Uru and comic cards, which are 2 pretty premium items to get. Finally, I want to talk briefly about the new uniforms. I purchased all of them, I played around with them, and I have to say I think that they're all at least good. I don't think any of these uniforms are bad. I don't think that if you like any of the characters and you purchase their specific uniform, you're going to be disappointed. However, I think a lot of people are going to ask, is there a Winter Soldier of this update? I don't think we have a standout candidate that's going to embody Winter Soldier the way that he transcended his lowly kind of F rank status and just catapulted himself up to A or S class, S tier power level. I don't think we have that in this update. So I think it's a little bit more contained, and I think everyone is somewhere between, you know, like a C plus and an A plus. Not bad, but nothing too insane in terms of power level jumps. I do think some standout candidates, if I had to choose some off the top of my head, would be Ebony Maw's new uniform. He's got lots of new skill animations. He's got a couple of skills that last for a really long time, so it does residual damage. And he's got new skill effects, like 10 seconds of mind control. Go figure what that does. Pretty powerful. Scarlet Witch also, she has some disadvantages with her new uniform, but some insane advantages, including a skill that has channeling, so you can check that out in the skill preview if you can't purchase the item. But it's kind of my combination, I would say, of like Goku's Kamehameha and the Kaioken with the charge up. So that looks pretty amazing, if I say so myself. Additionally, I think that Rocket's uniform is actually quite good. I think overall, Netmarble was very attentive to our criticisms of them and of these characters with these old uniforms, and they were very careful about fixing the gaps and filling in the gaps in them. So Rocket got a lot of survivability, he got guard hit, he got immunity, he got, I think, a heal as well, or a more consistent heal as well as a buff. Star-Lord got a lot of damage added to his kit. And then War Machine got everything. War Machine, I don't think, got the Winter Soldier treatment, but it's a lot better than anything he's ever had. I think it's better than the Punisher uniform or the War Machine Punisher uniform that Frank Castle got. So overall, I'm pretty happy with them. I think if I were to say on the kind of downside, I think Hulkbuster seems a little bit questionable, and Black Dwarf or Cull Obsidian also seems a little bit questionable, but I still have to do a lot more testing. I don't have a definitive answer on anything that's bad at this point, so don't take what I'm saying too seriously if you're disappointed by any of the uniforms that I mentioned at the end there. So let me know what you guys think of the update. Let me know any standouts that you've found, any bugs or any kind of cool features that you've discovered, any new ways for us to get some really awesome items or something, because there's always a few hidden features of every update that Netmarble just doesn't leave in the patch notes. They leave to us to find out, kind of Easter egg style. Subscribe if you enjoy the content and you want to support me. Hit the bell if you don't want to miss any of my content. And of course, if you like what you see, I hope to see you again tomorrow. Take care.